Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part five of Equations and Graphs of Ellipses, and we're going to do the following problem on this video. We're going to take this equation of the ellipse, which is in general form. We're going to write it in standard form. Then we'll state the center, we'll graph it, graph the ellipse, and we'll state the vertices, and then we'll check that at least one of those vertices satisfies the original equation below. So first of all, remember what the standard form of an ellipse looks like. Notice we have something in the form x minus h squared over a squared, h squared over a squared, and y minus k squared over b squared equals 1. Hk would be the center. In the general form, it just looks like a polynomial equal to 0. So this is in general form. So here we are. Here is the problem, and the task is to write it in standard form. So we're going to have to employ completing the square, which was a method we also used to put circles in standard form. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to group the x squared terms together and the x term together. So I'm going to put the 4x squared and, oops, it's a minus 16x. 4x squared minus 16x. And then I'm going to put the y squared and y term together. And I'm going to go ahead and write this negative 13 on the other side. Now, it won't be a problem completing the square with this y squared plus 2y because I basically have a 1 in front of the y squared, but I have a problem over here with the x terms because I have a 4x squared, and we want the coefficient to be 1. So if you have a coefficient of x that is not 1, you need to factor it out. So I have to factor out of this first parenthesis a 4, which is x squared minus 4x. Now, if you're not sure what it is to factor out, for instance, if 4 didn't go evenly into 16, you're basically just dividing that number by 4. So by the way, if that was a 9x and you're factoring out a 4, you would write 9 fourths. Okay, that's the trick. But this one was easy enough to do, so we are going to add something in this parenthesis to make it a perfect square. Right, and now we didn't have any problem with this one. We didn't have to factor anything out, but we're also going to have to add something to make that a perfect square. And on this side we have negative 13, and we see we're going to have to add two numbers. Whatever we put on the blank here, we've got to be careful from the first blank. Whatever I put on that blank here, I'm going to have to multiply it by 4, by the way. Because I'm really not just adding the number on the blank, I'm adding to the left side of the equation 4 times that number. Right, so let's go down and complete the square inside the parentheses. So inside the parentheses, we're going to make that a perfect square, but I have that 4 out in the front. Okay, so x squared minus 4x plus something, I'd think, well, what this, would this be a perfect square of? It'd be half of that coefficient, x minus 2. Which means I'm adding a 4. Right? 2 squared makes that a perfect square. So this is basically the same thing as that, right? 4 times x squared minus 4x plus 4 is the same thing as 4 times x minus 2 squared. Okay, for the second one, it's a little bit easier because there's not a coefficient in front of the parentheses. And so we have y plus half of 2 is just 1, so that's simpler. 1 squared is what would go on the parentheses here. The trick is what I really added to the left side of the equation. You didn't really just add 4, you added 4 times 4. So you have to add 16 for that little 4 right here. And we also added a 1. Tricky algebra. So what do I have here on the right-hand side? Negative 13 plus 16 plus 1, or negative 13 plus 17 is 4. So we're getting closer to the standard form of this ellipse. The only thing I have left to do here is divide both sides by 4 so that the equation is equal to 1. So let's divide both sides by 4. And when I did that, it also happened to take care of this coefficient up here, but if not, you'd have to deal with that at the next step. So this is an x minus 2 squared over what? Just a 1. Which I'm going to write as 1 squared, because to see it in standard form, sometimes it's easier to write it that way. Of course, this is the same thing as just x minus 2 squared, correct? It's fine. And we have y minus 1 squared over 4, or I could write that as 2 squared. So remember, it's up to you whether you want to write it over 1 squared or write it over, and you want to write this over 1 and this over 4, or you want to write 1 squared and 2 squared. But this is in standard form. And now I can see what the center is. The center is what? Okay. What's your h and your k? You set what's in the equation equal to 0? 2. That's the x coordinate of the center, and the y coordinate is negative 1. So now we're ready to graph it. Okay, so here was our original equation. If we did everything correct, this would be our standard form of the equation. And so then we picked out what the center is, so 2, negative 1. So I know where the center is. It's at 2, negative 1, about right here. And it's up to you if you want to dot it. I like to sort of dot it. It's easier for me to see the center. So I'd like to put a dot here. It's up to you. And so how would I draw the ellipse from here? Well, this one tells you you're going to go from that center one to the right and one to the left. So in the x direction, one in each direction. All right, and in the y direction, you're going to go two in each direction from the center. So you go up here and down here. And then that gives us a little, we are only estimating, right, what that ellipse looks like. We're sketching it. So those 4 points guide us. Now, I also asked for to write the vertices. So let's state the vertices. All right, so we've got 4 of them. What's this one? This one is 1, negative 1. So we've got 1, negative 1. And let's see, this one is 2, 1. This one over here is 3, negative 1. And one down here is 2, negative 3. So we've got those 4 vertices. And the question is, now we want to check our work. And that's the reason we want to put one of the vertices in, because we've said that this ellipse is going through all 4 of these points. We want to make sure we didn't make a mistake someplace. So that's the last thing we're going to do, is we're going to check at least one of those vertices. Right, so here are 4 vertices. In other words, we say that all 4 of these points satisfy this equation. We make sure that when you always check your work, you're always checking the original equation, because you might have made a mistake on step one. So let's just check any of these. All right, you could put the video on pause and try that on your own. How about we just check this first order pair? 2, negative 1. So I'm going to put in 2 for x and 1 for y. So we're just going to check 2, 1 into this equation. So we have 4 times 2 squared plus, and for y I'm putting a 1, so that's a 1 squared. And for the x I'm putting a 2. And for the y I'm putting a 1. And the big question is that, does that make that a true statement? So we have 4 times 4 plus 1 minus 32 plus 2 plus 13. Is that equal to 0? So we have 16 plus 1 minus 32, and let's see, 2 and 13 is 15. And yes, that does equal 0, doesn't it? Hopefully you could see that at this point it's equal to 0 because 16 plus 1 plus 15 is 32. And so yes, it checks. 2, 1. Let's just try one more order pair. How about 3, negative 1? So we're just going to check again in the original equation up here. So I'm putting 4 times, I'm putting in 3 for x. So this time it's 4 times 3 squared, right? Plus y squared. Now be careful here. Y is negative 1, so it's negative 1 squared. You have the quantity there. Then we have minus 16x. So 16 times, I'm putting in 3 for x. Then I'm putting in negative 1 for y. Right, 2y, 2 times negative 1 plus 13, and we want to know, does that equal 0 as well? So we've got 4 times 9 plus, remember this is negative 1 times negative 1, which is 1, minus 16 times 3 is 48, 2 times negative 1 is negative 2, plus 13, does that equal to 0? So if 36 plus 1 minus 48, let's see, how about doing this together? Negative 2 plus 13 is, oh, actually, make this even simpler. Negative 48 minus 2, that's negative 50 right there. Then I have plus 13, does that equal 0? And yes, because 36 and 1 and 13 add up to 50, so 50 minus 50 is definitely 0. So it looks like we did everything right, it all checked out. I know a lot of people don't like checking their work, but that's the only way you know whether you got the right answer. So we've done everything we were asked to do. We wrote the equation that was in general form here in standard form. We stated the center, we graphed it, and we stated the four vertices. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos which are organized by topic.